I'm literally battling. What should I put first? This one or this one? These last two, y'all, is just like, I don't know which one should go last. Come close to the screen. Like, it's a man's responsibility to take care of his household, take care of his person he's talking to. That's crazy to me. Like, I think that is the most disrespectful thing somebody could ever do. Disrespectful. Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. It's No Makeup Shannon, and we're gonna do another video of 10 things that I have learned in my 20s. Like, I have to do another one of these videos, y'all, because I just feel like there's so much things I learned in my 20s. Like, it's not just 10. So this is 10 again, but it's just added on to the ones that I did before. If you have not seen that video, go watch it. I feel like it's really, really nice. And it's a lot of the things that I've been going through, I would say, in the past year or two. So I definitely feel like, dang, like, I'm still going through this kind of stuff. But hey, y'all, so I low-key forgot that this is supposed to be 10 things I have learned in my 20s about relationships. I'm not talking about friendships, family ships. I'm talking about relationships with, like, these men that I've been around. Like, this is some stuff that I've learned, y'all. And I've just been like, you know what? I'm getting older. Some stuff I don't feel like I should have to deal with. And I realize that now. But yeah, y'all, this is a list of 10 things that I have learned in my 20s about relationships and dating, okay? Let's get started. Number one, listen closely. You are not his mom. You do not have to take care of him. Which, don't get me wrong, y'all, I have never taken care of a man. Like, I'm not gonna do it. But I feel like in one of my relationships, it's like like, he thought I was supposed to be catering to him. Like, no, babes, I am not your mom. Like, that's what your mom is there for. She's supposed to take care of you, not me. Ooh, I was just like, girl, what the hell? Like, but y'all, listen, don't be out here taking care of none of these men. Okay, that was number one. Let's move on to number two. Drop him, cut him off, get rid of him if he's ungrateful. I met this guy. Actually, I've been knowing him for a while, but me and him started talking. And I realized he's very ungrateful. Like, the little stuff that I do for him, I don't really do for people, yeah. But you know how some people have a thank you and I appreciate you and I, you know, I love that you did that for me. He more so had a, can you do that again? Can you also do this? Can you? It was always like a favor after a favor after a favor. And I'm just like, come on now. You're asking for too much. Like, I don't mind helping anybody, but you're asking for too much. And then I feel like it got to the point, y'all, too, where it was just kind of like, when I said that I couldn't do the third thing he asked me to do, he almost like was kind of now trying to gaslight me as if I didn't do enough or as if I never want to do nothing. And I'm just kind of like, I just did you two favors. Now I can't do the third one and you're mad? Cut him off if he's ungrateful. I'm sorry. If you don't want to cut him off if he's ungrateful, that's on you, girl, but I had to. That's something I learned in my 20s. Like, when they start to get ungrateful, just cut him off. Number three, your intuition, girl, is most likely on point. Like, I know sometimes we overthink and we may think the wrong things and we may assume, but sometimes if you're assuming something about somebody and it just seems weird, you know, it may be some truth to it. Like, I remember this one guy, I kept telling him, like, I just feel like you're not being honest with me, which I shouldn't have said all this, but, you know, I'm learning. I said to him, like, I don't feel like you're being honest with me and da-da-da-da and blah-blah-blah-blah. And I'm not going to give any extreme details because I don't want nobody to feel like, oh my gosh, she must be hurt that I'm this, and that. But your intuition is most likely right. But I remember telling this guy, like, I feel like this is the situation. This is the case. Now, sweetheart is in a whole relationship. Have like what, one or two kids, and this was like, y'all, this was like literally no time after we stopped talking. You're already like borderline married with two kids. Like, let's be for real. Crazy. And my intuition was telling me this, but I just didn't want to believe it because I'm just like, you know what, I'm overreacting. But no, you're not overreacting, okay? It's probably true. Number four, girl, this is one for me that I don't like to talk about it too much because I have never been in this situation, but I'm gonna just tell y'all what I've experienced and take it how you want to take it. But number four, if he is a little too heavy-handed, meaning like when y'all are arguing, he starts to hit stuff and throw stuff and move stuff out the way and do too much with his hands, I would leave. Because like, I understand people get angry, right? You know, we all get mad and we all be like, oh my god, like, you know what I mean? But like, I don't like the way you manage your anger. If you're that mad and you're gonna start slapping stuff down and pushing stuff away and just doing too much with your hands, at some point I'm gonna feel like your hand is gonna be all up in my face, and yeah, I don't want to deal with that. Like, I'm not gonna sit up here and say never ever ever, that will never happen to me, because I don't like to do that. But if he get too heavy-handed, then that just means something is not right. It's not clicking. Number five, y'all, and I'm gonna say this clearly for the people sitting in the back, no, I'm just kidding. But no, I feel like this is one of the hardest things to do when you first break up with somebody. The hardest thing to do is to leave them alone. But what I'm learning in my 20s, or what I have learned, is that once it is over and you call it quits, it should be over. Like, going back to somebody you just broke up with, it really don't make no sense, because I've learned that the same reason why you broke up with them the first time will most likely be the same reason you break up with them the second time. And it don't make sense to go back. Like, once you call it quits, once you're over and you're done, just be done with it. Don't go back. Now, if you go back, maybe there's a reason why. You know what? Sometimes going back work for some people, but what I have learned in my relationships is that when I go back, I experience the same thing over and over again. Sometimes even worse. So, if you decide to go back with him, make sure you're thinking about the good and the bad of your relationship. And is it really worth it to go back? Like, does that bad outweigh the good, or does the good outweigh the bad? So yeah, that's one other thing that I've learned, y'all. Never to return to a place I don't want to be in again. Number six, if you have to pay 50-50, half for everything, just understand that if you're okay with that, then you're okay with that. But if you're not okay with it, you're not okay with it. And just know that if you're paying 50-50 at the start of your relationship with him, you're gonna have to continue to do that throughout your relationship. Let's just say you're with this person for like 20 years. What is your life gonna be like if you're paying 50-50 for the next 20 years? I don't know about y'all, but when you first start dating someone, I feel like it should be an automatic. He should be doing stuff for you, right? 50-50 at the beginning of the relationship is just, it's weird. It's not cool. Like, it's just weird. Like, I don't know what better way to say that. It's just weird. I feel like a man should be a man and show me that you can take care of me. Why am I helping you take care of me? I don't like that. So to make a long story short, y'all, I feel like it's a man's responsibility to take care of his household, take care of his person he's talking to. Like, now let's say if you get into a situation now where clearly he can't do it no more, or clearly he's shown you like, hey, I can take care of you and you're my family and I'm gonna be there for you, but now I'm sick, you know, of course you gotta jump in and step in. I get that. But when you start having me take care of you at the beginning of the relationship, that's crazy to me. Like, I think that is the most disrespectful thing somebody could ever do. Disrespectful. And I'm not going to go too in-depth with what I'm going to say next, but we're going to talk about it a little bit. I feel like this is definitely a cultural thing that I've noticed, because I've definitely been with a few people from certain cultures who don't really want you to buy nothing when you're with them. But then I've been with some people now from certain cultures who want you to give them half. And I just be like, are you kidding me? Are you serious? Like, why am I going out to dinner with you and I'm paying for the dinner myself? Like, that's crazy. Y'all, I don't even remember what number that was. That was really a big one for me. Like, why you got me paying for my own meal? Girl, no. Number seven, stop asking for a title. Like, stop asking, what are we? I think I said this in my last video. Stop asking, what are we? What are we doing? Da da da. Like, why do I have to ask you what we're doing? I feel like when a man doesn't know or doesn't give you that title, he's playing games, or he's benching you, or he's playing around. Clearly, there's nothing better to say about this. Like, when he's not giving you a definite answer as to what y'all are, you're literally just there wasting your time. You're probably on a bench waiting for him to choose the next best thing. Like, why should you sit down and wait for him to figure out what he wants? If he cannot figure it out, I'm sorry, y'all. I'll be out of here now. I'm not playing them kind of games, because you're not going to waste my time. Number 8. When a guy starts to crush your dreams, you got to be careful of that, because it just gives jealousy. It gives you not doing this, you don't want me to do it. And if I'm just your girlfriend, girl, or I'm just dating you, like, why are you trying to crush my dreams? Like, I tell you, I'm going to school to be a scientist, and you're just like, you can't be doing that because of so and such. Like, I don't like that. Don't tell me what I'm going to do and what I'm not going to do. I don't like when people do that. Yeah, like, I don't like when people do it. I don't like when somebody I'm in a relationship with do it. And it's irritating. And it just, like I said earlier, y'all, it gives jealousy. It gives, you don't want to see me do no better than I'm doing now. Or you don't want to see me, like, get better. Like, I don't like that. Y'all, we're almost done. I'm literally battling. What should I put first? This one or this one? These last two, y'all, is just like, I don't know which one should go last. Like, I don't know which one is worse than the other one. But I'm gonna have to pick one of them. So anyways, y'all, let's get started with number 9. Sis, come close to the screen. When you see his gaydar going off, that means you need to find somebody else. And you need to stop playing with him. And he needs to go. I'm sorry, but, like, you like girls, right? Or women, right? Like, I kid y'all not. I've been with a few of these men, boys, whatever you want to call them. Because they act like children sometimes. Like, not in the like a weird way. But, like, some of these men just don't be men for real out here, okay? But when his gaydar starts to flash, I'm sorry, you gotta go. It can't get no better than leaving. Like, I don't know what else you're supposed to do. Like, I ain't gonna give no extreme details, y'all, but all I'm gonna say, in this little relationship that I call myself being in, the bestie was always checking me, and I'm like, bro, like, why are you checking me? One time, I was very uncomfortable. Like, I just felt like there was more to the story, and girl, I wasn't in the mix. And I don't like that. Like, I feel like it's nothing wrong with being close to your friends. It's nothing wrong with always hanging with your friends. But when we get to a certain age, you should be focused on having your family, building your own thing with your family that you're creating with your girlfriend or wife or whoever. But when your friend is standing in the middle of that, I'm sorry, I keep hitting this mirror. But when your friend is standing in the middle of that, and your friend is all up in and doing a little too much and asking questions and acting like they're, you know, like, I can't do it. Once people gaydar start to go off and I'm in a relationship with them, it's done. I'm not about to sit here and play with you. Mm-mm. Like, I can't do it. Like, I can't do it. Like, I'm gonna just leave this here. But this is one thing that I have learned in a couple of my relationships. When their gaydar starts to flash, just go. Because clearly they don't want me. Like, because I feel like when you're with a guy, y'all, and he allows somebody to shit on you constantly and talk about you and make fun of you, and he's kikiing or he's walking past like, I didn't hear nothing, like, you gotta go. Like, I don't play that shit. Like, y'all ladies, once their gaydar starts to go off and you just feel like there's just more to him than he's explaining to you, and yeah, just leave. I can't say it no better than leave. Like, I'm not trying to influence nobody to do anything, but why is my man acting like he's with him? Yeah, no. Mm-mm. Welcome to number 10, y'all. This is the last thing on my list, number 10. This is something I was battling when I was doing number 9 and number 10. I'm like, bruh, which one is worse? I don't even know. But let's get into it. Number 10. These men will bench you respectfully. Let me say it again for the people in the back. These men will literally bench you respectfully. And they will not care about it. And what I mean by respectfully, y'all, because they really be disrespectful. But I'd be like, whatever, like, it is what it is. But y'all, I've been in a couple of relationships where I wasn't sure what was going on. I was just like, bro, like, you know, because I was learning or whatever. I wasn't sure what was going on. I'm like, bro, are we together? Are we not? Like, what's going on? Are you talking to somebody else? Like, what's going on? What's tea? Give me the details. You're acting weird. Y'all, what I mean by these men will bench you respectfully is, like, these men will be flowering you with gifts, treating you really nice, talking to you cool, and, you know, everything will be all coffee and Starbucks and rainbows and chips and juice and, like, candy. And then out of nowhere, you start getting Twizzlers. Yeah, I said it. Twizzlers are nasty. You start getting Twizzlers, corn candy. Ugh, like, you just start getting this vibe that is just so weird. And then you realize, oh my god, is he gone? Like, is that him going down the street? I'm sorry, like, then you realize he's gone. And you're just like, what happened? Like, the truth is, sis, he was treating you nice just because he wasn't sure if he wanted you or if he wanted this other girl or if he wanted her or if he wanted them. Like, he don't know who he wants. So he put y'all all on a bench, but he knows there's one person that will just win at the end of the day, right? But he put y'all all on a bench, and he just sees, like, who's gonna win this prize? Like, who's gonna really, you know, who's gonna really win here? Is it you? Her? She? Like, so long story short, sis, he got y'all all on the bench, and he's gonna choose the best, like, contestant. And long story short, you don't know any of this is going on, but you realize when he start walking down the street and he's gone, like, where are you going for real? These men will bench you respectfully. Be careful of these men. Like, if you, I don't know y'all about how y'all are, but I'm very specific for real with some stuff. If I see you're acting the slightest bit of different, it starts to throw me off. And it starts to make me feel uncomfortable. And y'all can call it insecure, but it's not insecure. It's just me wondering, like, why are you changing? Why are you acting like this now? Versus yesterday, you were acting completely different. Like, I don't like that changing stuff. But anywho, y'all, that is the 10 things that I have learned about my dating life and relationships in my 20s. Like, I have one more year in my 20s, so I feel like it's just right to make these kind of videos and let people know, like, please don't make these kind of mistakes. If you see the signs and the gator is going off, believe that the gator is going off for a reason. Anywho, y'all, thank you for tuning into my video, and I hope you come back and watch more videos. I'm gonna do another one of these videos because these are just fun. Like, I'm stuttering a little bit, but these are just fun. And yeah, y'all, come back for the next video. I will talk to y'all later.